Who we had a chance to check out, UFC 246. Was that an insane fight or what? McGregor with those crazy shoulder strikes in the clinch, followed by a kick to the head, and a fury of strikes that ends the match in 40 seconds. Hey Punch Fitters, this is Chris Hunter, owner of Punch Fit, and I've received a few emails from our subscribers asking for a more advanced style workout, and after seeing UFC 246, I thought now would be a great opportunity to put you through one of my MMA-inspired workouts. Workout 17, I use kettlebell movements to fatigue every major muscle group, cardio to get you gas, and finally wrapping it all up with an all-out war on the heavy bag. Here are the movement standards. We will be doing 3 rounds set at 5 minutes. Inside that 5 minutes, we will be doing 4 movements and end the round with some heavy bag work. Starting with the kettlebell push-up to snatch, go to the plank position with your hands on the kettlebells. Lock out your core and control your descent as the kettlebells will want to roll on you, and then push yourself back up. Once the push-up is completed, jump your feet to the outside of the kettlebells. Keep your shoulders slightly in front of the kettlebells and higher than your hips. Starting on the right side, explode up, driving through your heels, and in one fluid motion, take the kettlebell from the ground to above your head. Safely return the kettlebell back to the ground and repeat on the left side. Then go back to the push-up and repeat the sequence as many times as possible in 45 seconds. I'm looking for low sets, 5 max. If you can complete this sequence more than 5 times, go with a heavier kettlebell to slow you down as long as you're able to maintain good form. Take a short 15-second break to transition into the kettlebell hang power clean to lunge. Standing with both kettlebells hanging at your sides, start on your right side and power clean the kettlebell to the rack position. The kettlebell on the left will remain in the suitcase position for now. Keep your shoulders above your hips, lock out your core, and keep your back straight throughout the entire movement. Complete a front lunge with a controlled descent and drive through your heels to return to the start position. Return the right kettlebell to your side and power clean the left kettlebell to the rack position and repeat the movement. Again, I'm looking for you to complete this sequence 5 times in 45 seconds. If you can do more than 5 reps, increase the weight if you feel you can manage the added resistance. Take another 15 seconds to transition to the kettlebell buck, trap, and throw. This time, you'll be starting on your back. Bring your heels as close to your butt as possible. Grab the kettlebell by the horns with the bottom of the kettlebell pointing towards your head. Start by driving your hips as high as possible, using the momentum to push the kettlebell off your hips and into the air. Control the kettlebell's descent and have it softly land behind your head. Now drop your hips quickly and use that momentum to get the kettlebell back to the start position and finish with a crunch. This time, complete that sequence 8 to 10 times. Next is the jump rope. Now I really want you to go after it. As a matter of fact, if you aren't tripping over your jump rope, you are still inside your comfort zone and I need you to go faster. However, if you trip up multiple times because the jump rope is just too much of a challenge for you right now, put the jump rope down and do speed jacks. The goal is to push yourself and really get that heart rate up. Now this is the part you've been working towards, and if you did it correctly, your mind is telling you to quit. But this next interval is going to determine if you're a champion or not. As soon as you finish the jump rope, I need you to throw on your boxing gloves and for 60 seconds, go after that heavy bag with everything you got. Punch, elbow, kick, and knee your way to victory. I need you to fight as if this was the last 60 seconds of an MMA match and you either need to knock out your opponent to avoid the fight going to decision or rack up as many points as possible to ensure that you are the clear winner. If you have a ground and pound bag, adjust between standing and groundwork in that 60 seconds. Don't have either? Don't worry. Sub the bag with shadow boxing. Once completed, only give yourself a 1 minute break in between the 5 minute rounds and repeat 2 more times. If you consider yourself a champion and find this workout too easy, skip the 15-second break in between each movement altogether and extend the workout to a total of 5 rounds. If any of these movements look foreign to you, be sure to reach out to a certified trainer that can help you pick the appropriate weight based on your current fitness level and coach your form throughout the entire workout. All right, enough talk. Grab your kettlebell and boxing gloves and follow along with me for the first round. It's time to get fit. All right, guys, let's get started with round one. We are gonna be going in 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. Complete a push-up,
kick your feet up just to the outside of the kettlebells. Your shoulders should be slightly in front of the kettlebells, but higher than your hips. Keep your back nice and straight, driving through your heels, snatch the kettlebell from the ground to above your head in one fluid motion, and then repeat on the other side. Now, when you do this, I'm only looking for low reps. You should only be able to complete this sequence about 5 times in this 45 seconds. Any more than that, and you're going to want to go heavier as long as you can control the weight. And we are going to be done in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. All right, that was an awesome round, but don't go very far. That 15 seconds is going to go by very quick. As a matter of fact, get back to those kettlebells, pick them up, clean the right kettlebell so it's in the rack position, and go. From here, what I want you to do is a forward lunge on the right side. Then bring the right kettlebell back to the start position, clean the left kettlebell, and do a forward lunge on the left side. It's important when you do this particular movement that you keep your shoulders stacked above your hips the entire time. So lock out that core so that those shoulders don't float in front or behind your hips. I'm looking for low sets again here. So complete this sequence no more than 5 to 6 times. If you can do more than that, increase the weight if you can control it. The main purpose now, or the main goal, is to fatigue all those major muscle groups before we get to the heavy bag. 3, 2, 1, and time. Only have 15 seconds. Quickly transition to your back. Have your feet as close to your butt as possible. Grab the kettlebell by the horns with the bottom of the kettlebell facing your head. We're going in 3, 2, 1, and thrust your hips up high. Use that power to generate force. Get the kettlebell up over your head, but slow the descent down to avoid injury as the kettlebell lands softly behind your head. Drop your hips quickly and use that momentum to get the kettlebell back to the start position. From here, do a small crunch, rolling your shoulders off the ground, and repeat this movement. This particular movement, you should be able to get anywhere between 8 to 10 sets done. Make sure you exhale every time you thrust your hips up and when you bring the kettlebell back down. We are done in 3, 2, 1, and time. Go ahead and put that kettlebell off to the side. Get up quickly and grab your jump rope. All right, you have to hustle, grab that jump rope. Get ready, we're going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Now what I really need you to do here is push yourself hard. By the time you're done with this jump rope, I need you huffing and puffing. I need you completely gassed out. As a matter of fact, you should be going so fast on the jump rope that you may even trip up a few times. However, if you're tripping up because the jump rope is new to you or it's not something that you're very good at, just throw the jump rope off to the side and do speed jacks. Overall, what I'm really looking for you here is to make sure that that heart rate is up and you are completely gassed out by the time you put those gloves on. We're done in 3, 2, 1, and time. All right, quickly make it over to your gloves and your heavy bag. This 15 seconds is going to go by very quickly. Get those gloves on fast because we're going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Attack that bag with everything. I always want some piece of your body on that bag at all times. It's either going to be a fist, an elbow, a shin. Just make sure that you're constantly striking. Don't forget to throw in some sprawl so you can see what it feels like to get tired by going to the ground and getting back up. Attack, attack, attack. You've got to win this fight. Now transition to the ground and pound. Go after your opponent. You worked hard. You got him to the ground. Knock him out. Oh, he's still got some fight left in him, though. Get back up to the heavy bag. Go after it. Attack. Throw in some sprawls, some kicks. Get yourself exhausted. Keep going. You still have 15 seconds. You got to win this fight. Go, go, go. You're doing good. You're doing good. All right. Transition to the ground for the last 10 seconds. Go after it. Throw those punches. 3, 2, 1, and time.
Hi. Hey. Nice, Don.
And that was round one. Take a minute break and repeat this 3 to 5 times, depending on your fitness level. Whew. Need some water. And that was workout 17. Thank you for following along with me during that workout. And if you can, go ahead and repeat that 2 to 4 more times. I wanna thank my lovely wife, Aneta, for helping film this video and making this all possible. If you haven't already, subscribe to our channel. Make sure that you give me a thumbs up if you like this video and click on that bell, because our next series of videos is going to be kettlebell workouts. So if you only have one kettlebell or two kettlebells at home, Aneta's gonna show you how to use those effectively. So we have another 4-part series coming up. Until next time, get fit.
Get strong.
And get tough.
Yes, we did it. Oh my gosh.
Well, yeah. I always do it.
I don't know about you, but I do.